This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
So today's it. Today you're...
Oh, yeah.
You're on the... Wait, are you on or off the wagon? Off the wagon.
You're on the wagon.
You're on the wagon.
We always go through this.
So hard.
Yeah.
You're on the wagon.
Yeah.
I feel like when you're on the wagon, you should be drinking like you're going through a corn maze or something.
No, you fall off the wagon and you start drinking.
I woke up.
You guys went out to Daly's, I seen.
Yeah, we did a bar tour. Dive bar tour.
Fun.
We had a designated driver, so we were all getting stupid.
Good for you.
I guess I woke up in my garage on my carpet. I have my Harley on a UW logo carpet.
Yeah.
I woke up on my carpet.
It's not a good sign, dude.
I don't know. I was trying to put it together. I think it was around 4 because Christy got home at around 7 in the morning. There was a neighborhood bash going on. Windsor AF, dude.
I get it.
So I woke up on the carpet, crawled into the house. And I guess next thing I knew it was noon. So I don't know.
Damn, bro.
I think I got roofied.
You're kind of old to be falling asleep in the garage carpet. Christ sakes.
Now that you mention it, now that you say it on 50,000 watts, it doesn't sound so good.
You know?
At the time, I thought, well, anybody can make this mistake.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to come to work and get some perspective. I didn't know.
Yeah.
Like, this could be bad. Or it could be good.
It's kind of concerning.
Oh. The last thing I remember was drinking Hendrix out of the bottle.
Eesh.
Yeah. She goes.
Damn, dude.
Well, it's expensive. I'm like, if the bottle's almost empty, she's like, just drink it.
Ay.
How about that?
Gin's always the last drink they start on before they go way downhill. It's fine. Should probably move on, dude.
I think that's where what's-his-name went off the rails with his hamburgers eating off the floor. Mr. Baywatch.
Yeah. Are you going to Hasselhoff me this year? I swear to God. I'd be like, Mushroom Swiss, Quick Trip. We're going to have to move you to a pureed diet. All you can have is the mashed potatoes from Quick Trip, the mac and cheese. That's it.
I might be doing
that slides good down your throat.
I might be doing the show via remote broadcast from the Tellurian facility.
I don't think they're going to take you. I mean, screw dry January. Why don't you just take like 3 days off?
That would be a record. That would actually be a record and unobtainable at this point.
You know,
totally unobtainable goals.
These are called smart goal setting.
Totally unobtainable goals.
Yeah.
How dare you?
Yeah. You need to have a timeline and it needs to be achievable.
Yeah. Scoob says hi. Scuba told me to tell you hi.
Awesome. I love Scoob.
Out of Daly, so he had a good time on. He had a DJ. What was it? We were laughing at the DJ's name. Oh, crap. What was it?
Sammy Smoothballs?
No, but it was like that. Not awesome. Cheesecake, like not onion breath. It had a weird... crap.
Let's see if I can find it.
Oh, dude, it's
Pork Chop.
Pork Chop!
Yeah?
DJ Pork Chop was going to drop the hammer at Daly.
That's awesome.
Did you make it to midnight?
No.
No kidding.
We were asleep by 10:30.
I saw a percentage of people that stay. What do you think the percentage of people is that make it to midnight?
Like over the whole world?
I don't know. I don't know if it's the whole world. I just saw the thing, and so I don't.
I'm going to say 35%.
It's 43% only make it to midnight.
Yeah. We whooped it up last year pretty good for New Year's Eve.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. This year, though, we're rolling into 2020 poor. So
2020 poor.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
like P-O-O-R?
Yes. Okay. Like living like you're poor, because mostly we are. Yeah, so I wasn't about to drop $400 on a New Year's Eve.
Oh, yeah. No.
You know, whole shebang.
Right, right.
We did that last year.
Sometimes low-key is...
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Low-key was fine.
It's okay.
But, next year we're looking at doing some in the Dells.
Ooh.
Saving up.
Yeah.
Big thing. Get all fancy.
Don't stay at the hotel right behind Niggs. There was mold on the shower curtain, a blood spot on the bathroom floor.
Are you trying to make me horny? It's working.
Hey, you know what? I haven't even gotten to the used panties I found under the pillow.
Yeah.
Wait till you really hear what's going on.
Give him a sniff.
And then the guy, I swear to God, had the balls. I was leaving to go, can you leave us a good review on whoever?
He's like, please help.
Oh, air conditioner didn't work. Pure mold on the shower curtain. Blood spot on the bathroom floor. And the front door barely locked. And you get all of this for $69.
That's pretty sweet. Sounds like a good deal.
Do you have to pay over $100 to not get the blood stains?
Yes.
You really do?
100%.
It's amazing how the ratio from price to blood on the floor.
$35.
It's $35.
Yeah.
And that's not a lie.
100%. Well, that was like when we were driving out to Sturgis and then my hotels.com app or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were looking for a place to stay along the way. And they were like, oh, look, Super 8. Ordinarily $90, you get a deal for $8. Yeah. And I was like, I'm not even going to entertain the idea of only paying $8 for a hotel room.
Yeah.
There's no way.
There's like $500 is too much.
Right.
$60 isn't enough. Isn't enough.
Yep. 100%.
Like, I need $100 just to think about.
Right. And even at $100 here, I'm expecting it to smell musty.
Yeah, absolutely.
You
I
know?
Don't expect anything. I don't expect the windows to lock. I don't expect anything. Right?
Totally.
Right. The heater smells. I mean, yeah, I get it.
People, relax.
What a complete waste.
We are killing it online. Have you guys checked the comments?
Of cyberspace.
Smoke That Skin Wagon says, you guys are killing it.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
We're internet sensations.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
Florida, but that's America's wag.
It's true. Okay, police charged a 20-year-old woman that repeatedly beat her boyfriend with a Christmas tree during a pre-dawn skirmish. The pair's Florida residence. Christmas Eve. Ah, yes. According to the court filing, Miracle Rivera, 20, and the victim, 24, engaged in a verbal altercation about infidelity early Sunday morning. Cops say the victim separated himself from Rivera and relocated in the living room. It was about 3:40 in the a.m. on Christmas Eve. You know this can't be good. You're arguing about somebody cheating. It's 3:40 in the morning on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
This is a recipe for disaster.
Oh, yeah.
Rivera followed the man into the living room where he's lying on the couch when Rivera picked up the Christmas tree with her Hulk strength and began to beat the victim with it repeatedly.
New Christmas tradition at the house.
That's right, dude. The size of the tree is not detailed in the criminal complaint. The tree battering, investigators allege, resulted in the victim sustaining numerous minor scratches over a lot of his upper body and arms. Yeah, that would kind of suck, get beaten with a tree.
It's never the size of the tree that's important. It's the angle of the angel.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Angle.
That didn't work.
Angle. She was arrested for domestic battery and booked into the jail, and then she was released on Christmas Day. Well, that's pretty nice. She was... Able to be out, huh?
Her name was...
Celebrate Jesus' birthday. It's a Christmas miracle, you some bitch.
Her name is Miracle.
Yeah.
Her rapper name is Miracle Whip. And then she beats everybody in the front row with a Festivus pole.
Oh, man. I'm paying for that. I'm getting the VIP upgrade. The tree was not seized as evidence. all right, another Florida. A Florida man was so enraged that someone wouldn't speak to him that he intentionally rammed his car into their house. That'll help. Fabian 40 years old, facing charges of criminal mischief and projecting a deadly missile into a home. After police say he drove his car into a house, suburb of Fort Lauderdale. Police said that Campbell wanted to speak to someone in the home who wasn't available, prompting him to purposefully crash his car. Man, you go from one to talk to someone to crash into their house. That's a little
needy.
Yeah. Wow.
That's a weird one.
Definitely structural damage, seeing as how he's parked in the refrigerator right now.
So mad that Florida State didn't get into the playoffs. Taking it out on each, they're eating each other.
Oh my God, you're so sportsy today. Mm-hmm. You're like Sporty Spice over there.
Like you.
Sporty Carpet.
Sporty Carpet. I laid down on my UW carpet in honor of the beleaguered and beaten Badgers. I would pay a tribute to them like a dog that loses his owner.
It would nap on your sports carpet.
Sports carpet.
Okay. Well, there you go.
This is what I
left Florida.
This is what I'm really sticking around for. The news closer.
All right, here we go.
Oh, you're done. You've done.
I'm already done.
Hit me. Hang on. I'm ready.
Newer, gayer, dumberer. That's JJO News.
Newer, gayer, which I didn't think was possible. Newer, gayer, and dumberer.
Newer, gayer, dumberer.
I like it.
Don't.
I do like it. It's got flair.
Scratch your beard.
Newer, gayer.
Dumberer.
That's a bold statement, dude.
Thank you.
Newer, gayer. What's the gayer part?
It's just gayer. It's just more gay.
Just
gayer.
Your goal is to be as gay as possible.
No, it's. Remember, I got the complaint that I wasn't gay enough.
I didn't know there was a committee. It's like prom committee.
I didn't know there was a committee either.
We thought uploading to the cloud was something completely different. The JJO Morning Show Podcast. Johnny and D, JJO.
All right, now we all knew class action lawsuits is a quick way to get rich. Who cashed in their $3 from the milk lawsuit?
Oh.
Anyway, Tampa Bay area woman is suing the Hershey Company for $5 billion in a class action complaint that alleges the company falsely represented some of its Reese's peanut butter products. The complaint was filed Thursday in Florida's Middle District Court. According to the docs, the woman filed the complaint on behalf of herself and all other similarly situated individuals who purchased a Reese's peanut butter product based on false and deceptive advertising.
Oh,
the suit says, that they violated Florida's Deceptive and Unfair Trade Practices Act. Ooh. The issue centered around the complaint has nothing to do with taste, but everything to do with looks. She says that the Reese's peanut butter pumpkins falsely represented as having explicit carved out artistic designs. Look it, because it alleges that there's a jack-o'-lantern carved into the pumpkin.
Yeah, on the wrapper. Okay.
Right. But when you actually open it.
Oh, there's no smiley.
There's no smiley. It's just a plain.
Ah.
How dare they, sir?
Wow. How do you get through life without having your little smiley face on your chocolate cup?
Packaging clearly shows a jack-o'-lantern.
Clearly.
The actual candy inside, no face, faceless, vaguely shaped like a pumpkin.
Don't you feel like.
Just look at it. It just looks.
Oh, yeah, that's horrible. I can't eat that. Yeah, I can. About 80 of them, because I'm fat.
Come on, lady.
What, dude? I feel like Hershey's is big enough to have people killed and made disappear. I believe that.
Dude,
you don't think there's a Hershey mafia out there somewhere?
Well,
making sure you don't dip into the billions and billions of chocolate profit.
Due to the absence of decorative carvings on the physical candy, the woman alleges many people have been tricked and misled.
Hmm.
Sure, I'll sign up for this one. Complaint goes on to list several YouTube videos as evidence of other people complaining about being duped by Reese's Packaging.
Well, what's the suffering part? Don't you have to show damage? What's the damage?
No, you don't have to show damage.
Just false. Okay, I got
false
you.
And deceptive okay. Yeah, advertising.
I got you.
Yeah.
Well, Lucky Charms aren't exactly... I mean, if you say they're magically delicious, that's a conversation we can have. I don't know if they're magically delicious.
Well,
I mean, opinions vary.
Yeah, that's different. That's different because, that's subjective, I suppose. But here, she's saying, look at all these packagings allege or appear to show that there is a jack-o'-lantern in here, and it's not. It's just a damn pumpkin.
Wow. So, okay. I guess. Mm-hmm. Is it going to court?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
I would argue that they say Reese's peanut butter pumpkins, not Reese's peanut butter jack-o'-lanterns.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So, whatevs, will to be continued.
Would that be
on my class action lawsuit page?
Yes, I was going to say, is that a class action? Or, or is she greedy and want it all to herself?
$5 billion. For her and other people.
But what looks... it's weird. This is a weird case. She's not wrong.
She's not wrong.
But, I mean, is she being a poopy head? Yeah. But she's not wrong.
Can't Reese's just be like, all right, we'll redo the damn packaging and not have a smiley face on the pumpkin.
So you only bought the snack because it would make you happy, and you thought if the little Reese's had a smiley face, you would feel happier.
Right, you thought that's what you were getting.
Yeah, you thought you would. You weren't happy because you bought something that was supposed to make you happy that's not there to make you happy. Do I want to punch her in the face? Of course I do. Is she right? Of course she is.
Yeah.
Really weird.
So...
What?
Let's see if this is on my little page here.
It's like the chocolate Karen, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what to do with my hands.
Just a lot of, holy crap, there's a lot of lawsuits here. You can hop on.
All right, 3210941, instant legal poll.
Okay, I'm on Top Class Actions, which I go to all the time. They do not have the Hershey one on here.
Ah, she's greedy.
So... Well, it might not be a federal one. I think it's just a Florida one right now. There's a Costco lawsuit. Sparkling water. There's all kinds of different. Man, if you want some free change.
What does the wrapper say? What's the wrapper?
It says Reese's Peanut Butter Pumpkins.
Okay, so a pumpkin. Okay, well, let's get into the minutia of this case.
Yeah, a pumpkin versus jack-o'-lantern.
Let's get into the minutia.
I love you, dude. Thanks.
Can I have one of those?
I'm a mess.
Can I have one?
I'm a mess.
What did they give you?
A new fob.
Ah. That's...
Well, I had to smoke...
You're the Christmas miracle.
I had to smoke all my weed before today. And so I did that, and then I woke up, and I'm a mess. And what?
You smoked your fob, too.
So high. So high. So high.
Probably some resin left out.
We think it was the fob gremlin, which sounds like this. That's the fob gremlin eating the fob. He's like, okay, you stoners, I'm out of here.
Yeah, he's like, get out of here.
That's enough. All right, let's get into the minutia of the case here.
Yeah.
So it says pumpkin. Now, when I hear pumpkin, I don't necessarily... What is carved into a pumpkin? That becomes a jack-o'-lantern.
Once it's carved, it's a jack-o'-lantern.
Uncarved, it is a pumpkin. So technically, Reese's has a case here just because of the wording.
The wording is correct. The image is not. They need to put, like, not what the actual candy looks like a little disclaimer underneath the pumpkin.
Right. No smiley face on pumpkins. If they were going to, if it was a Reese's jack-o'-lantern, then she'd have a stronger case because you need teeth and little scary eyeballs or whatever.
For sure.
So I'm not sure. I mean, look, here's my thing with these cases. It's always the price goes up because you got to litigate, and now who ultimately pays for this if it goes through? You and I do, the Reese's peanut butter eaters, which I am. I love Reese's peanut butter. So that'll just get priced into the Reeses for a lad a penny. See, we all suffer.
Damn inflation.
Smaller
pumpkins, more money.
How would you rule if you were on the jury on that one?
She's right. I hate it, but she's right. They need to not have that picture on there. It's stupid.
What if Hershey makes the argument I just made?
Well, what if Hershey just changes the packaging and then settles out of court? They're like, we'll give you enough Reese's pumpkins to last a lifetime, lady.
You're going to die from a chocolate obesity. Take that. Boy. This is not how I wanted to start 2024.
Yeah?
Arguing about Reese's peanut butter cups, which I love.
Yeah.
One of my favorite candies of all time.
Same.
Reese's peanut butter cups.
Yeah,
I like them in the little actual cup as well. Delish. Can't get enough of those.
The Christmas cookies with the gosh darn mini Reese's in them are pretty awesome, mm-hmm. too. It's so good.
It's weird because it's frivolous, and yet...
She's got traction.
She's probably got traction.
Yeah.
It's so...
Yeah,
it's weird that you love something so much and yet want to sue them into oblivion. You know, if you were part of the Hershey's fan club, you'd be like, look, you guys, I'm doing this as a favor because I love the product so much.
I don't know, dude.
Is her damage $5 million? No.
No. Hey, whatever, dude.
But they usually settle to make those go away because that's easier than
right,
sitting
than
through.
Keeping on paying the lawyers.
Right, right, right.
That's about $5 billion, by the way.
$5
billion? Not $5
million. Hershey makes $5 billion?
No, that's what she's suing them for.
$5
billion? Yeah.
You know, if I only get $20, you got to start high.
You got to go to the table high, dude.
And if I only come out with $20,
yeah,
pretty happy.
For sure.
And go to McDonald's. Son of a... Hello?
Hey, I read a good take on this. Somebody posted about this case and said they agreed with her, but somebody down in the thread said basically the jack-o'-lantern cutout is like the bite mark in the other packages. You're not buying these thinking somebody already took a bite out of it. They're showing you that there's peanut butter inside the candy.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, they're selling these packages with bite marks taken out of them. People are like, oh, yeah, I want one of those. They're not thinking there's a bite mark taken out of it.
You know what Hershey could argue? They could say, look, if we call it, it's a pumpkin. If you want to make it a jack-o'-lantern, you can carve your own little smiley face in.
Yeah.
They could go that way.
I'm just sick of these people taking up time and resources for these frivolous lawsuits.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know why you want to be mean to Hershey's. I mean, they give me pleasure and, you know.
To be in the spotlight,
money.
She wants 15
money.
Minutes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's why candy...
Is she already rich?
I don't know. Who's got enough money to pay a damn lawyer right now, for Christ's sake? But
right.
He's probably...
Who hosted a party?
Yeah, right? God damn. All right, thank you. Good point on the bite mark. I like
it. Well, she seems... let's see. Alex Jones was ordered to pay $1.5 billion to the Sandy Hook families. And now she wants $5 billion. For a Hershey's picture with a smiley face,
mm-hmm.
You're a disgrace. In the context of life, you're a goddamn disgrace.
What about the lawyer that took the case?
Well, of course he did. Of course he did.
Is he a disgrace?
He's an ambulance chasing chocolate eating moron that's going to ruin it for everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen of the court, the smiley face is merely a suggestion. If you would like to carve it into a jack-o'-lantern, you're more than welcome.
You're on your own.
You can be an artiste.
Whoa.
You just cough some blood up from all the gin.
You need a maneuver there.
I need a chocolate maneuver.
Maneuver.
Ooh, that sounded bad.
Okay, it did. Right into Stinkfest. Amazing.
Dumbing down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe. to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO. Another one bites the dust.
The world's oldest chicken has snit the bed. Chelsea, Michigan. The age of 21. Peanut the chicken died.
Mm.
Jesus Christ.
It's a lot of bad news to absorb on a Tuesday.
Well.
What? So, well, that's a nice life.
Should have wrung the damn thing's neck before it turned 21, for Christ's sake, just hopping around being all miserable.
Don't talk like that.
Anyway, it looks like Peanut here lived a long and eventful life in Michigan.
Yeah.
Peanut's owner, Marcy Parker Darwin, announced on a blog post on Wednesday, December 27th, that Peanut died in her sleep in the early morning hours on Christmas Day.
That's how I want to go. Not like my grandfather screaming behind the wheel of an automobile. Wait, how did that joke go?
So bad.
Might have screwed that up.
Anyway, she died laying on Darwin's chest, which is how we all want to go out, smothered in the bosom of a random lady in Michigan.
I'm not happy with Michigan right now.
All right. I don't care.
All right, so the chicken, then, what do you do with that thing?
She left a hole in my heart, Darwin said on Thursday, December 28th. Even my husband this morning said, boy, the house just seems empty without all this chicken crap everywhere.
You know, after I found out the bird died, I drove by the house and gave the old broad the bird because the story was too sappy.
Go on now. Peanut lived on a Chelsea farm. With Darwin and her husband, Bildo. Darwin helped peel Peanut out of her shell more than 21 years ago.
Mm.
The pair was bonded ever since. In January, Peanut was crowned as the world's oldest living chicken by Guinness. She was 28 at that time, but the bitch turned 21 in May. Led to worldwide attention and interviews. Peanut spent some of her life living outside with the other chickens and animals, but she lived most indoors in a living room coop. With her daughter, Millie. These people are absolutely insane. Darwin described Peanut as sassy and independent. She was never shy, especially when it came to chirping and posing for a camera. Darwin believes Peanut's death was due to her age. What was your first clue?
21. That's a good life for a cat. Extraordinarily long life for a cat. Horse is right around 20 to 25.
Well, yeah. Some of them will go to their 30s.
Some, yeah. The rare...
Yeah.
What else? That's too old for a dog. What's the oldest dog that's ever lived? Probably 20.
I'll look it up.
Yeah, probably 20.
Yeah, so she thinks that Peanut's death was due to her age, but also due to heartbreak, because her daughter Millie died at age 15 on Halloween, and then her old rooster boyfriend Benny died on December 7th.
Oh, my God. Like the old chicken housewives of L.A.
I believe chickens grieve just like we do, Darwin said, as she dipped her chicken wing in blue cheese dressing.
The same chicken she was tenderly holding a day before, which has now turned into a chicken wing.
The average lifespan for a bantam hen like Peanut is roughly 5 to 10 years.
Ah.
Yeah. Peanut's longevity was due to the love and care that Darwin gave her.
Like a lot less for a broiler chicken. They last about 5 weeks in there.
Well, yeah. They're genetically altered
to
grow so fast they're getting damn legs don't even work.
Pump full of steroids like Gao, the UW chancellor in LaCrosse.
Goddamn, that juicy thigh is nice.
What does Professor Chancellor Gao and a chicken have in common?
You can put your whole fist in there.
Correct. That's the correct answer. Yes. You got it on the first try. I'm shocked. And it's all laid out there in the video under Juicy Anniversary. It's right there. You don't believe me? Google it. Be terrified.
Why do you make me do these things?
I call foul. I call foul.
Yeah. Oofta.
That's a great life. 21 years.
Yeah. What a lucky chicken. And holy crap.
What is that in human year?
Oh, I don't know. Hold on.
Probably like 300.
I was going to look at world's oldest dog. First.
300 years. I'll say the oldest dog was, I'm going to say something like 26. I don't think that's possible. Maybe for a small lap dog.
A livestock guard dog with a life expectancy of 12 to 14 years. This one, though, Bobby, lived to be 31 years old and 165 days.
Whoa! That's amazing.
What? 31?
He had no idea where he was the last 11 years of his life. He just pooped and fell over.
Yeah, no kidding. All right.
That's incredible.
Chicken years to human years.
Yeah, there you go. That one I don't know. Is it more than seven?
Okay.
That chicken. Keep effing that chicken.
So, a three-year-old chicken is roughly 33 years old human years.
Oh, my God. That thing's...
Each subsequent chicken year equals 10 years.
Oh, okay. So,
the chicken was like 180-some years old.
That's amazing. That is amazing. He probably was blind.
Wanted to die.
Yeah. He wanted to die back in like 2005 when they rang in the new year.
Yeah.
He didn't want anything to do with us.
Right.
Like, oh my God, can I just die?
Chicken keeps walking to the goddamn stump.
It's like
laying its head down. God!
Cut it off! he's like the...
Just do it already! Laying in the yard waiting for a hawk.
He's like the Sam Kinison of chickens. He's like, cut it off! Just cut the head off! Go ahead, cut it off!
Totally.
The Sam Kinison of chickens.
Oh, no.
Man, oh, man. Yeah, that's incredible. What a life.
Yeah.
I don't want to be like that. I don't need to be that old.
I don't think you have to worry about it.
Not after this weekend. This weekend, it took 12 years off of my life.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast. With Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and Dee, nowhere but JJO.